Capnometry is the measurement and analysis of carbon dioxide in exhaled air without a continuous written waveform or record. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, capnometry serves as a non-invasive way to measure the partial pressure of carbon dioxide in an exhaled breath. Technically speaking, capnometry is the measurement of carbon dioxide in a respiratory gas, while capnography is the graphic display of this measurement. However, for the sake of this video, we will be using the two terms interchangeably. But during a capnometry reading, a patient's exhaled breath is measured and the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is plotted in wavelength form on an X and Y axis grid. The display shows wavelengths and number measurements that tell us how much CO2 is being exhaled. And for the normal value range, a normal capnometry reading falls between 30 to 40 torr. In respiratory care, capnometry can be used with any patient. However, its primary clinical use is to monitor general anesthesia or moderate sedation. It is also commonly used after intubation in order to confirm that the endotracheal tube was correctly inserted into the trachea instead of the esophagus. Additionally, capnometry is helpful in the assessment and monitoring of patients who are receiving mechanical ventilation. As a respiratory therapist, the two primary parameters of a patient to monitor is their oxygenation and ventilation. Pulse oximetry is a reliable and effective way to quickly assess a patient's oxygenation status. For ventilation, we can use capnometry to instantaneously assess how well carbon dioxide is being removed from the body. It provides information about perfusion as well by displaying how effectively carbon dioxide is being moved throughout the circulatory system. Lastly, it also provides information about a patient's metabolism by displaying how effectively carbon dioxide is being produced by cellular metabolism. Again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.